Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, hang on. Before we get to today's problem, I have a quiz. It's a pop quiz. That's right. Hey, if anyone out there is teaching an Excel class, you should give your students this pop quiz today. Here we go. Question A. Fill in the answers. Answer 9 has been given for you. And answer 9 is sum. Go ahead. Click pause on the iPod. Grab a piece of paper. Write this out. All right. Well, what the heck could the question be? Sum. Number 9, sum. Well, if you have ever done a subtotal, you recognize that using the subtotal function, 9 is the argument to give us a sum. And what are these other arguments? I know after sum is variance and variance p, and before it, standard deviation p, and before that, just regular standard deviation. Average is the first one, then either count or count A. I'm going to go with count and then count A. All right, now. Few others left here. I know min and max are in there. What's the other one? I'm gonna have to go look in product. Why do I always forget product? Okay, so max, min, product. That's the way that I would answer this quiz. I think that's the right answer now. You can go check the subtotal function. The point here is that when we use the subtotal function, there are 11 different calculations that we can do. And sure, we use sum all the time, count or count A once in a while, but frankly, I've never used any of the other 8 of them. And these same 11 calculations are in a pivot table. Now, when I got this next question from Rod last night, I have to tell you, I did not think of those 11 calculations. Rod says, hey, I have data. It's an outline form, so there's level 1 and level 2. I have some amount, and then I have a field. It's a binary field. It either says, is this step complete or not complete? And I need to see for level 1, is every single item in level 1 complete? And so yesterday I wrote a sum product formula basically that said, hey, go see if all of the level 1s that match this row have the complete field equal to a 1 or not, and put, you know, a 1 or a 0 there. But I woke up this morning, I said, wait a second, there might be a way to do this just naturally using the pivot table. So insert pivot table, I'm going to put it right here next to our data, so that way we can see the data as well. Click OK, and I'll put level 1 and level 2 along the side. Of course, amount is easy. It's going to sum that up naturally. I'm going to take the complete field and put the complete field there, and you see that we get to see how many are complete, but that's not what I'm interested in. I want to change that calculation. So I'm going to choose sum of complete and go into field settings, where you see that we have the same 11 calculations here, including product. Well, what is product? Product takes all of those numbers and multiplies them together. So think about it. If all of the completes are 1, then this is going to show up as a 1. If any single step is not complete, then that 0, 1 times 1 times 1 times 0, is going to cause this result to be 0. Click OK, and we get to very quickly see which items are complete. So here, item A, step 2, everything's complete, which means that because all of step 1, 2, and 3 are complete, then A is complete as well. Now, down in item B, step 1 is complete, but step 2 and 3 are not complete, so the product of 1 times 0 times 0 is 0, and we get incomplete. All right, so this is actually the answer we want. The problem is going to be for Rod to convince the people who read this to understand that 1 means complete and 0 means incomplete. We're going to go very, very arcane here to solve this problem. I'm going to go into field settings and choose number format. And while you've probably been in the custom number formats before, there is a very unusual type of number format, and it has the zones. We're going to put in 3 zones. What to do if it's positive, what to do if it's negative, what to do if it's 0, each zone separated by a semicolon. So, in quotes, complete. That's what I want to see if the answer is positive, and then a semicolon. If it's negative, which it will never be, incomplete, and then another semicolon, and again, if it's 0, incomplete. The last one would be text. That's not an issue here, so I'm not going to put the 4th zone in. Click OK, click OK, and there you see that we changed those zeros and ones to complete and incomplete Very, very cool. Using the product function, I have to say, in 20 years of using Excel, this is the first time I've ever actually had a use for the product function within a pivot table. Thanks to Rod for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.